Hi guys, welcome to a new episode of NextGen BI Group. Can we search PDF contents within PowerBI? Imagine having a folder full of PDFs and being easily able to search their contents and refresh some of the information in your dashboard. In this episode, I'll show you how to achieve this feat using entirely free tools. First, we'll dive into extracting the PDF text contents using Power Query. Then we'll leverage Python to convert the PDFs into a format that can be seamlessly integrated with PowerBI. Finally, we'll develop a dashboard with search capabilities. Don't be intimidated if you have no prior experience with Python. I'll guide you through the process step by step, making it easy and accessible. However, if you haven't watched the first episode where we covered how to embed a PDF file into PowerBI, I highly recommend you to do so, because I covered how to install and set up Python. You'll find a link in the description for this episode. Finally, pause this video for a moment, grab a cup of coffee, and let's dive in. Here we go. We have these five files. We want to be able to extract the contents of these files in both text format to search it in PowerBI and in Base64 format to be able to visualize it in PowerBI. One important thing to check for those PDFs, we want to make sure that they are editable or the text is selectable. If not, you need first to convert it to a selectable format. You can use scan and OCR in Acrobat, or you can use free online tool. You can just search convert PDF to editable format, and you can easily convert your PDF into a searchable format like this. Okay, having that covered, let's go back to our scenario here. The first step is to extract the text from those PDFs. To do this, we need to go to PowerBI, get data, hit the more options, select a folder. We don't want to use PDF directly because we want to process multiple files. So we want to do this step once for all the PDFs within a directory. Connect, you need to provide the folder path. You can either browse or paste it if you have it. Now we can see here all the files in the directory are listed. Go to transform data. And there is some transformation we need to do. First of all, let's make sure that we only select PDF files. From the extension here, make sure it's always selected to .pdf. So if the directory contains other type of files or temporary files, for some reason, they will be ignored. Now, let's remove all the unwanted columns. We'll just keep the contents and the name of the PDF. Right click, remove other columns. Next, we'll expand the contents from here. The compiler will open for us in order to decide what to do with the contents of the PDF. As you can see here, it will select a sample file and apply the same for all of them. So we will take the first file in the directory. Now, make sure not to select from this list, just select all of it, because if some PDF having more pages and contents than the others, you want to select all the contents by clicking on the main contents here. Once you do that, click OK. If you see here, it already created a function for us that applies the same process for all the PDFs in the directory, and it also removes all the other columns that we don't want to remove, so make sure to bring them back. Just delete this step and this step, and let's start from here. So this is the transformed contents. This column we want to keep, and this column that shows the PDF name we need it to. So let's remove others. And from the transform file, let's expand it, click OK. As you can see here, we got all the contents of the PDFs, including both pages and tables. Because we'll establish a link between the text contents and the PDFs in Base64 format in PowerBI, we don't want to use the tables. We will use only pages. For this reason, we'll filter out tables and keep only pages. And let's remove the unwanted column. We want the ID of the page because we'll use it to establish the link. So we'll keep this and keep the data content and the name. Remove other columns. And we'll expand the data to show all the text content. Just make sure that everything is selected. Hit OK. Here you go, you have all the text content expanded. Now, as you can see, they will come in so many columns because PowerBI will try to divide the text into paragraphs. So what we need to do here, while all the columns are selected, is to right click, and merge them. Separator, we don't want any separator. We'll use only space. We'll name it text contents and hit OK. As you can see here, we have one column that merges all the text contents of the PDF. There's one last thing to do here. We want to create a field that will be used as a link between the text and the Base64 format that we'll see in the next step. First, let's remove the PDF extension from those files. Right click, replace values.pdf. Keep this empty to replace it with nothing. Now we'll merge this with the page ID in order to establish the link. Right click, merge columns. We'll use custom separator and we'll name it link. Here you go. You have everything you need. We have the link and we have the text contents. And we're done for the first step. Let's load it to the dashboard. Okay, we are ready now to move to the next step. Now we exported the text contents of these PDFs. The next step is to export the Base64 format in order to visualize the contents in PowerBI. We will do this using Python. From the start, open the development environment. And guys, if you haven't installed Python before, I recommend you go back to the first episode where we covered how to install Python. Moving on, I have the code developed and ready. We'll open the file. This is the code file. And this is our code. I'll go quickly through the code. It's similar to the code we covered in episode 1. However, there's one important part added. I'll go through it. But before we do that, there's an extra library we need to install for Python. And the way to install libraries in Python is straightforward. You just go to the start, cmd, and you use this command. I'll just copy it here and paste, hit enter. As you can see, it gave me a message that the requirement is already satisfied because I already installed this library before. But for you, it will go through the installation process. That's it. We have the library installed. Let's go back to the code. We start by defining a function to process the PDF into Base64 format and export it to CSV file. This function takes two inputs, the directory and the file name. Now, the first step in this function is to define a dictionary. This dictionary will store the headers for the CSV files. We have the PDF name and we have the page reference. And then we have the Base64 format. And we allow 50 fields just in case we have huge files. The next step, defining the CSV directory where the CSV file will be stored. We use the input directory and we'll name it PDF. Now this part creates the CSV file in the directory and write the CSV file headers. This part here opens the PDF and extract the contents. Now we have a for function here that loops through the pages of the PDF and extract the contents and process them. First, it takes each page content and save it into a temporary file here. Now here we extract the Base64 code from each page of the files into a string and we strip the text from the binary reference here. Here we delete the temporary file we created earlier. Here we define a reference for the page numbering. We want to make sure it has the same format like the ones we created in the text export step. And here we open the CSV file for append and start adding the Base64 contents to the CSV file. We'll store the PDF file name and the page. And this part here divides the string into 32,000 chunks and store it in different cells. This is the whole function ready. Now we can use it to process all files in a directory. Here we feed in the directory, the location where the PDFs are. Make sure again to use double backslashes. And this part here loops through the files in the directory and process them using the function we mentioned above. That's it, guys. This is the entire code. Now we're ready to run it. From run, it's run module. And we are done. Here you can see this is the CSV file contents. It's exported all the files into different pages for us. Now close this file, get back PowerBI. Get data, text or CSV. Select the file. Now go to transform data. Okay, here we have a few things we need to do. Just simple transformation to make sure to establish the link between the text link and the PDF contents. Let's rename this actually to PDF's contents. First of all, from transform, let's use the first row as headers. Filter out the blank. Okay, the next step is to create the link. We will use it to link between the text contents and the PDF contents. We'll do this by duplicating those two fields, but we'll keep the original ones because we need them for the slicer. So let's just duplicate this one and this one. Now we can merge them. Select this first, then this, right click, merge columns. We'll use a custom separator. We'll use dash and we call it link. Close. Now we have the link. That's it. We don't need to do anything else here. Let's close and apply. The next thing, we need to create a calculated column that will merge all those fields. And just to make our life easier, I put this in an Excel sheet like the one we used in episode 1 for all the 49 cells. So let's take the output, go back to the dashboard, right click, new column, name it PDF's contents, paste, and here we go, we have our calculated column ready. Now, from relationships, we can see that Power BI already created the relation using the link. Let's just make it both sides. Cross filter directional, that means both will filter each other, although we only need from the text to the PDF contents. Now let's hide the unwanted fields from here, select all of them, and is hidden, yes. That's it, let's go back to the dashboard and start importing the visuals. From get more visuals, we import the PDF viewer, type PDF, you'll find this PDF viewer. I've already added it. I don't need to do it again, but if you open it here, you can add and it will be added to your dashboard. Same we'll do for one more visual, which is the search slicer. Just type search and you will get the search slicers. I usually use this slicer, so I'm gonna add it. Okay, then I have the two visuals imported to my dashboard. Now let's start working the dashboard. First thing, let's import the background. From format page, canvas background, browse, and navigate to the background. Make image fit, then transparency 0, and we have the background. Let's start adding the visuals to the canvas, starting by the PDF viewer. And we'll feed the PDF content column, the calculated column we created earlier. As you can see, we have this message showing that you need to filter to one document, one PDF document, in order to be displayed. So we need to utilize slicers to be able to filter it down. We'll add the search slicer first and use the text content field, which is the field we want to search the text from. Adding our slicer here, and we need one more slicer to show the source and the page of the document. We will just use the default slicer. With two levels, the first level is the source, the second level is the page. That's it, we are all set. You can see here the source comes with all the pages. And we can actually start using the dashboard. Since all the files we processed are financial reports, let's try, for example, using stock as a search term. Here you go, all the pages containing this term is already filtered. Let's check one of them. Here it shows the stock performance graph. Let's try one more. From Meta, we can see the stock holders here and so on. Let's check one more. Let's check for Microsoft, for example. Here we go. Stock world showing here, and so on. Since this year is 2021, probably COVID is mentioned here. Let's see COVID. We can see the effect of COVID also showing here. For Amazon, for example, we can see reference to the same word. COVID-19. Okay, that's it, guys. In this episode, we saw how to incorporate search functionalities within Power BI for the PDF text contents.
While the SER functionality by itself is available in various tools, the true value of this solution is leveraging PowerBI analytical insights. One, to gain quantitative insight on the contents of the PDF, and two, to establish a connection with your data. For example, imagine you having so many contracts and reports in a folder. You can import them into PowerBI and count the occurrences of certain terms on those files, which allows you to do deeper analysis. If there is enough interest, we might explore this use case in future episodes. I'm confident that you have other use cases you want to explore on your own. To give you a head start, I shared all the contents covered in this episode, including the Python code and PowerBI file, in a link in the description. If you like this episode, show your support and hit the like button. And if you're new here, subscribe to the channel. I also highly appreciate your feedback, so please feel free to leave a comment. Guys, our work is not done here. While the search function is useful, we encounter difficulties in locating the search text within the PDF file. I believe we need to find a solution to highlight the search text within the PDF file, within PowerBI. Is that possible? Perhaps. Let's uncover the solution in the upcoming episode. For now, peace.